Tomasha. Oh. Do you like that film?
No.
What we're doing behind the scenes.
I like.
Hey, welcome back to our Stupid Reaction DVD. It's Corbin.
I'm Ashley.
I'm Rick.
And Paul's on
Instagram and Twitter. Juicy content.
It's so juicy.
It's so freaking.
Really, juicy, juicy, juicy.
And today we reacted to a behind the scenes of the Tomasha with the
happy.
Director.
Makes me happy.
I think he's going, he says inside the scene, I think it's the scene in the bar.
Cool.
We're going to talk about it a little bit. This is the director.
Look at that hair.
That. So say hi.
Director of that scene or the whole movie?
I think
no,
the whole
they had
scene.
27 directors. just one for each scene.
Yes, here we go.
There was only 27 scenes.
Hi, this is Imtiaz Ali. And we are talking about a scene from the film Tomasha. It's a scene that became very popular. It's in a cafeteria where the two characters, played by Ranbir and Deepika, called Veer and Tara, have a lover's squabble or a disagreement.
Yeah.
To say the least.
You can say that.
To begin with, I feel that it's a modern metropolitan tragedy that we have to make our personal emotions public. I remember when I was shooting or not shooting, maybe just some place in Europe, there was a girl sitting on a bench and crying. And she was disconsolate and people were coming and going and some of them were looking at her as well, but she couldn't help it. And this is where this scene is inspired from this girl and that thought. So right from the beginning, Ved is being elusive and Tara, that is Deepika, wants to meet and confront. And Ved wants to go away because he is not so sure of what he's feeling. Right at the outset, artificiality from Ved because he actually is there at the cafe first. He sees Tara coming in, then he comes up, takes out his phone and pretends as though he's not seen her. So it's very difficult for him to be real at this point, so he's being artificial in order to hide from her. You know, sometimes you really fear those people that can see through you.
Should we? Yes, no.
So, I feel that one of the reasons why I think people might like this scene is the fact that the two aspects of this character, Ved, are very distinctly seen in the same person. And you, of course, the important thing that I have to say over here is that you need an actor like Ranbir or like Deepika to play these scenes. It's, if you look at it, it's very performance oriented. It's only because they did it so well that it's good. I think with Ranbir and Deepika is all, it's always just to make them understand. Even before I think I'd written the scene, while in the office, I remember Deepika and Ranbir and I were talking about it. There was a half-written scene or something and then they just went through that and then they got it and then they improvised it. This includes that time where he moves away from her, goes out of the cafeteria, goes and hides somewhere. She comes back looking for him. She finds him. And then certain things that happen, the fact that she sits down on the floor, that he walks away from her even then, and those things actually happened in that improvisation. I didn't even have that, those things in mind. And he's saying I won't do anything crazy today, and he's also pretending to be hello ji, kya hal chal. It's not possible for him to just be an ordinary person either, you know. So the fight is actually inside him, and that becomes the proactive force for this scene.
Kyunki tumne mujhe reject kiya.
The moment he says, kyunki tumne mujhe reject kiya, after that, if you see the way Tara is talking, the way Deepika is talking, she's so careful. And she knows that she'll say one word and he will fly off the handle.
Koi complex hoga tumhare andar, jisko maine touch kar diya.
She uses the word complex. The moment she says complex, I think that's what the trigger was for him to blow up.
Bolo, sorry. Go on.
Say it! It's a very cruel scene, I feel. I feel that the guy is constantly aware of the fact that he is being unfair to her. Because she does not deserve this rudeness and this bad treatment. But it is said that you can only hurt those people that you love. If you love somebody more, you can hurt them more. And that's what's going on. And the The cruelty is in the fact that he's aware of what he's doing. And he can't stop himself because he finds in himself some volcano erupting at this point of time.
I'm sorry. Okay. I was so upset.
For Deepika, I'd like to say this, that this scene was shot over two nights. Because this place, this cafeteria, social, which was I think the first social that I had seen in the country, was in Delhi in Hoss Khaas. Now, there's a point of time where Tara would start crying. She would break down. Okay, and then when we shoot angles, right? So to bring her back to the point where she was not crying and then take her back again over that bridge of breaking down had to be somehow negotiated. Now, I know her very well and I'm extremely fond of her. So I was watching her and I knew where she was going emotionally. And I was always cutting the shot. Sometimes a great shot was going on and I had to cut it because I didn't want her to break down, because then there would be no recovery. Mm-hmm. And then the whole of the next day would be left. I remember myself watching her, that I would stop this shot in a good shot also and say, this is fine, let's do that part, just to like bring her out of there and not make her break down. Mm-hmm.
It's nice of him.
Yeah,
very sensitive.
So kind.
Beautifully shot. I'm sorry, I'm not like praising my work. Like now that I'm watching this film, it's been a while, and I feel I'm watching somebody else's film. Mm. Really, I remember certain things, but I'm not taking credit for anything that's good here. But very nicely shot by Ravi Varman. I feel the cinematography is nice.
Brilliant.
I'm proud. This is a visual from my film. And then we come to this very symbolic shot, which even while it was going on, because the emotion was so pure, where he is looking at her standing and she's looking up at him sitting.
The lighting's beautiful on that
shot. For us, it was very cinematic even in that way. Because there was, you know, I think things are cinematic when people are so full of the character they're playing. And he's trying to release himself from her. There are certain things you do that are shameful. You do them alone. You don't do them in front of other people. You start singing this "Tu kisi aur ki jaagir hai, jaane ghazal." And he's behaving like that in front of her. Ironically, he is in that way so naked in front of her. It actually makes me feel ashamed to see all this. Maybe that's why people liked it, because they could also feel this feeling of shame, you know. A modern girl, why would she take this shit? But then why would any woman take shit? But she is, and she can't even help it. That's shameful itself. And it's aggressive, it is desperate. I think it's desperate, this scene. Everything about this scene is extremely desperate.
Yeah.
And this is the important
thing.
He's hiding and she's trying to get him out.
There are a lot of things that are said over here that are significant. One of them is this, that sometimes you become something in front of somebody and that is your true self. Mm-hmm. Whether it is harsh or pleasant, but it's your true self, and that is exactly what Tara has done to Veer in the film. There were a lot of comments about Ranveer's character Veer being bipolar, and I think it comes from scenes like this, the fact that he is playing two personalities or two behavior. I would like to clarify that bipolar is a
different
clinical condition.
Exactly.
in psychiatric.
Thank you.
I'm not going to say that he's bipolar, because that's really, it's a very technical and a clinical thing. But loosely used, bipolar, jaise bolte hain pagal hai. So bipolar behavior is there, you can say.
Nice of him to differentiate that.
Yeah. The fact that they're struggling. He's struggling to get released from her, and she's struggling to catch on to him because she knows that there is something very precious for both of them. And finally she hugs him, and at that point of time there is nothing to do for both of them, and that's when the song begins. The little trivia about the song is that we made one song for this situation, and then after a while, it was all good, great lyrics written. It was a rough version, and everyone loved it. Deepika really loves that song. So we went there and we shot that whole song. It was not a lip sync. If you notice, there are very few shots in it, very few shots, especially inside the cafeteria. And so just the song had to hold for a long time, and people who were in the frame were, had to be connected to the song. So it was very specific. That's why I wanted the song in a good stage before the shooting. So anyway, we shot with that song. And then later, Rehman sir said, should we try again for that situation? It's not non-lip sync, right? So we can, try one more time. I said, why is this man doing this? It's a great song. People love it. They won't even entertain the thought of having another song here. But he said, okay, let's. But then ultimately my whole thing is, yeah, why not? I already have this. I don't know what Rehman sir felt about this. And then he came up with this song. I think it was the fourth song, not even the third. There was something in this tune, it has come into the line, Behti Rehti Hoon Main. You know, that part, the quality of that composition is such that I just couldn't not make this song, the final one. Deepika believes that the previous song was better. Most of the crew believes that various other songs of this 1, 2, 3, 4 were better than this one. But this became the most popular song of the album for sure. Difficult shots to light because, again, very few shots, just 2 or 3 of them. The one that I liked and have kept the most in the edit as well is just a nightmare for a cameraman because it stares straight at a table. You don't use glycerin and stuff like that because there is never a brief of you have to cry at this point, never.
Good.
I don't think crying or tears coming out of your eyes is any better acting than if it is
not. No, it's not.
It happens sometimes.
Exactly. And sometimes it doesn't.
Inside the scene of Tamasha, and I feel very nice and much more in love with Deepika and Ranbir now after having watched this.
Me too.
Scene and this song.
Absolutely. You're a very talented man, sir. That was great, and I love that. It was confirmed. We thought it was a lot of it is improvised.
A lot of it had been improvised. Yeah.
It looked like because that certain things in there, you can't write it. Mm-hmm. You can't write what they do.
Yeah.
I guess writers would disagree, but...
Well, you could, but it's very difficult to make it look germane and natural because it can be contrived. Because
the actor knows that he's supposed to do that as opposed to just doing what he feels in the moment.
Exactly.
Which I'm glad he's the type of the director that lets performers perform, doing honor to the script and doing honor to what he wants, but letting them... Because I think everything comes out a lot more organically when it's, and that's why it's film is probably the most collaborative art process there is.
Yeah.
I think.
I agree.
And clearly aware of the toil a scene like that can take on an actor and made sure he didn't go too long on some shots because it was out of sequence.
Yeah.
There's no way she could go, if she went to the full place that was going to take her and it's a 2-day shoot for that scene, she'd be fried. It'd be totally fried.
And day shoots aren't just 7 hours. They're
12 to 15 hour days. A lot of sitting around.
Yeah.
And then you've got to find that place again and then pull back and be where you were before it. So very, very sensitive for him to do that.
Yeah.
I loved how much he talked about their processes.
Yes.
That was super cool because he could have talked a lot more about just his standpoint on the directing, but he talked about the cinematography and what he did with the actors. I just loved that.
Yeah.
Yeah, I like this format of the director actually because they're the one with the insight in to the scene.
Yeah, I've wanted to see one of these with Sanjay and Vishal Bhardwaj, and I'd love to see. We kind of saw Zoya did it with Gully Boy, that long extended one,
or Anurag Kashyap as well.
We saw that as well.
Which
I'd love Farhan Akhtar. I'd love to, any director. It's just it gives you insight into how they run things on set and their artistic vision, and it is always enlightening.
That was awesome. Yeah. Let us know what other ones we should have.
He's gonna be okay, really.